What's up, guys? It's your favorite twins, and today we are finally listening to Taylor Swift's 10th studio album, Midnights. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I was really sick when the album first dropped, and I was so mad we could not.
If you were mad,
then I was beyond
mad. Do you know what it's like for a Taylor Swift album to drop, and you have to sit in the corner watch as everybody else plays? Because you can't listen to it?
Do you know what it's like for a Taylor Swift album to drop and while everybody blasts and, you know, basks in the lavender haze, you're sitting here coughing up a lung?
You know, you may have that one, but I still blame you.
But the hype is still there. I mean, listen, Midnights is on track to sell over 1 million copies. Y'all, you are pulling those kind of numbers on your 10th studio album.
No singles,
no promotion. The only kind of promotion was like revealing the track list.
Where, like, she holds the phone upside down. Like, I don't even know what that was, but
insane.
You know what? It worked. Midnight. The stories of 13 sleepless nights scattered throughout her life. If that doesn't intrigue you, I don't know what does.
Listen, and all the vinyls create like a clock.
First of all, speaking of vinyls, okay, you know what I did get to do though? While he was coughing up that lung, I was coughing up that dough. Okay, I went out to Target. I went to go buy the album. I went to get the lavender edition. Because I saw it and it was staring at me and she was talking to me.
Yeah.
And I felt like I was being taunted.
No, you were.
Okay, and I didn't like that.
We're also wearing
lavender.
Listen, I'm not saying we've already done the damn thing.
I just feel like we came prepared.
You know.
But like, we're not prepared.
Yeah, I'm not prepared, but I'm prepared. Like, it's what to expect when you're expecting.
Right. Like, a lavender haze is gonna hit us.
And I'm gonna.
Yeah. We are meeting Taylor at midnight.
We are meeting Taylor at midnight.
Okay. She's also dropped a 3 a.m. edition.
Yes.
Okay, and we're gonna get to that. This is going to be the standard edition.
Yes.
Because if you were there, whether you were there or watching from a distance, you know that this album dropped at 12, and then the 7 songs dropped at 3 a.m. Okay, so we're gonna figure out a little something.
Before we get started, you know we have to shout out our Patreon. Thank you guys so much for joining over there. There's gonna be some Midnights content over there. So, if you want to meet us and Taylor on Patreon at midnight, join. This is so different. I love this.
Like, what pocket is she in right now? It's like,
because it's
dance,
like alternative.
It's kind of alternative.
Wow.
Put it like,
I will put it.
This is already so different.
Oh my, beyond
from
different.
Evermore and Folklore.
Red.
Tempted to even say it's probably, she's going in a direction I'm not sure she's gone in yet. We haven't listened to everything.
Yeah.
But I feel like I've heard enough to know that this does sound fresh for Taylor.
Oh,
I feel
very.
Like the song was upbeat, yes, but it was still very chill
at
the same
time.
Chill. That's why I know that there's like a genre of some sort that they call this.
Yeah, I can't put my finger on.
Maybe they have it here. Electropop, indie pop, dream pop. It's something there. Like it's somewhere in that pocket.
I love it because it taking inspiration from Mad Men and kind of just being in this being completely engulfed in love and kind of like the illusion that it creates for you.
Yeah.
It's, but Taylor said, I don't give a fuck.
And with all that we've seen her kind of go through with her dealings.
Yes.
With the media. The song does appear to be about her boyfriend Joe.
Okay. 6 years.
She's admiring the fact that like he doesn't care. What about what's been said, what
yes,
he's seen.
Yes,
you know,
very
he's
true.
Not really concerned with all that.
And then the next one being maroon, so
another color.
Kind of keeping that color.
Yeah, and we, you know, Taylor, I feel like, has always kind of played with colors and, like, the emotions that they bring about.
Yeah.
But, you know, I think it's a great way to start it off as well. I don't know if this is going to be, like, the basis of the album.
Yeah.
I don't know what the album's going to be based in.
Yeah.
But if it's love, great.
If it's self-discovery,
which, you know,
great.
She did say that, you know, hopefully you'll find yourself in that midnight.
In this turmoil.
Yeah. Really love how the song is just about appreciating your partner for appreciating you. And just being willing to, I guess, take that chance on you. Because when you've been through so much, sometimes love can look a little hopeless.
Yes.
So when it feels this good, you want to stay in that lavender haze. I love the 1950s callback, because that's obviously where she's pulled the title from.
Yeah, exactly.
Bringing in that 1950s idea and how women were viewed and treated and what was expected of them. And her just saying how, like, that's what they want from me.
Yeah.
I'm not giving them that.
I'm not giving it. Yeah.
And yet I found a person who can still appreciate me and love me. Even when I'm not conforming to those ideals.
Yes, absolutely.
So,
absolutely.
That's a really beautiful thing.
Yeah, I love this. Okay. Definitely carried over that feel.
When the morning came, we were cleaning incense off your vinyl shelf, cause we lost track of time again. How we end up on the floor anyway, you say. Your roommate's cheap ass screw top rosé. That's how. And I chose you, the one I was dancing with in New York.
Okay, good.
No shoes, so groovy, on my t-shirt when you splashed your wine to me, and how the blood rushed into my cheeks, so scarlet it was.
I love that. I love that chorus.
Love that.
I love that chorus.
And I love how they all,
shades of red.
When the silence came, we were shaking, blind, and hazy. How the hell did we lose sight?
Hazy, lavender haze.
The rubies that I gave up.
Rubies, red?
Yeah.
Lost you. The money saw on my collarbone. The rusted wool between telephones. The lips I used to call home. So scarlet it was. Over me, that's a real fucking legacy.
Ooh.
Legacy.
Ah, she wanted y'all to feel that.
Over me, that's a real fucking legacy.
Wow, I love that.
The burgundy on my t-shirt when you splash the wine into me. There was maroon.
Love the way these songs are taken out.
Yeah.
I love that.
You know, once again, dealing with a color, I love the contrast of the two. I feel like Lavender Haze is obviously about being in love. It's very bright. It's very positive.
Yeah.
But maroon feels like we're peeling back a layer of what is maybe behind that Lavender Haze, or what lies in the center of it a little bit more.
Yeah, absolutely.
Anytime Taylor plays with red, I always think of passion. I always think of fire, desire.
Yeah.
And just, you know, how she says red is that burning red. Maroon is kind of like that in-between, where it could be both.
When describing the colors of red, it, maroon to me is like that gray area, that middle ground. I love how descriptive this song was.
That chorus,
like,
I'm telling
the
y'all.
The lyricism is insane. What you left with me is so engraved in me.
Yeah, which is like painting a split here, though. Like, I'm reading even it, like, saying that, and I wake with your memory over me. That would insinuate that, like, maybe we aren't together now.
But honestly, I was gonna say, this song doesn't strike me as something that's current. It's something that was.
A little bit. I can get with that, too.
It's to me something that was.
I could see both. I think that the perspective changes throughout the song. Like, goes from reminiscing to being in it. Maybe as you reminisce, you feel yourself back
because
in it.
Because the burgundy on my t-shirt was splashed. So everything is very past tense. It was
maroon.
It is,
yeah.
So I love that the song about what was, but just the mark that it left on her. Yeah. That's insane.
And that red color continues to follow
Continuation is just insane. Oh, I love that.
I think Maroon's going to end up being one of my favorites off the album, to be honest.
Yeah.
But I got to keep listening because I get too excited. Yeah.
This is such a... Wow, I like this. I have a thing where I get older, but just ever wiser. A callback to like folklore stuff.
Yeah. Become my afternoons. That's become afternoons, okay. When my depression walks the graveyard, shift all of the people. I've ghosted instead there in the room. Okay, can we just acknowledge that?
I love that plan.
Can we acknowledge that? Yeah.
When my depression works the graveyard shift, all the people I've ghosted stand there in the room.
Because as you're feeling that depression, memories of people, situations can come back.
Everything.
And suddenly all of that is like standing in front of you.
And coming after Maroon. I should not be left to my own devices. They come with crises and vices. I end up in crisis. Realize all this time. Cause you got tired of my scheming for the last time. It's me. Hi. I'm the problem. It's me. I'll stare directly at the sun, but never in the mirror. It must be exhausting. Always rooting for the anti-hero. Love her voice.
A sexy baby.
No, a sexy.
Okay, I don't know what that one was, but
a sexy baby.
But okay.
But I get it.
Oh, do you? Okay, but this idea of an anti-hero.
Anti-hero.
Don't ever embarrass me like that again. Once again, an anti-hero is in the middle because they're not the villain.
Yeah.
But they're also not the hero. They're right there in the middle once again.
And to me,
and that's just the complexities of life.
No, literally a very self-reflecting song. And these are the thoughts that you do have when you're up and alert and awake at midnight. You just start thinking about everything and your thoughts bounce from wall to wall.
And so never staring in the mirror. Never facing yourself.
At the sun.
Yes. Which is blinding. So you'd rather remain blind than
look at reality.
So many people do that with life. They go through life never wanting to address what's really going on inside.
Yep,
and essentially they're blind.
Come on. Did you hear my covert narcissism? Might disguise as altruism, like some kind of consciousness. One day I'll watch as you leaving, and life will lose all its meaning. For the last time, it's me. I'm the problem, it's me. And time, everybody agrees. Must be exhausting, always rooting for the anti-hero. I'm sorry.
I
think this song is perfect.
When you are close to people who, in a way, self-sabotage, it becomes hard sometimes to root for them because it can become exhausting.
Yeah.
And absolutely. So, like, for her to say that everybody at tea time agrees, that they can see this about her, that she'll stare directly at the sun and ignore her own
but
problems.
But you're still trying to root, hoping they'll come to terms and they'll have a self-realization. Right. And it's like...
Yeah, but it's even for yourself, I think. You can become tired of rooting for yourself and you kind of just... Given to those devices and vices. That's why she says she can't be left with them.
Exactly.
Another thing I'm noticing, her pre-courses are being rewritten this time. I have this dream, my daughter-in-law kills me for the money. She thinks I left them in the will. And then someone screams out, she's laughing up at us from hell. Hey. You say, you know, look, all right?
I know where I'm going.
I've accepted my fate.
I'm accepted it.
And guess what? You're not in the will. It's me. Hi.
I'm the problem. And this sounds like at one of those like AA meetings where it's like, Hi Taylor,
you're back.
I love this part. Everybody agrees. Always rooting for the anti-hero. Right. Oh, I love that. Okay. Okay.
You know, this
I'm adding
is,
a like.
This is the lead.
I'm adding a like.
This is the lead single.
This is the lead single.
Rightfully
and can
so.
I be honest?
Hey. She's 3 for 3 right now.
Hey. That's one of my favorite Taylor songs I've heard.
Really?
In a, like.
You're just putting her on up there, huh?
In a minute. And don't get me wrong.
Evermore
I love,
is crying.
No.
Folklore is crying.
No, I love Folklore. I love Evermore. Anti-hero.
Yeah.
That?
Anti-hero.
That to me is a perfect song.
Really?
Yes.
I mean, I can agree with that.
Even down to the bridge. It's me.
Hi.
Taylor does have songs where she takes accountability.
Yeah.
And the self-reflection mm-hmm. and you know, realization.
Many.
But this song to me is like an I Hate You song. Like, this, I'm literally gonna take all my worst qualities mm-hmm. and put them to a beat. Because
that's exactly what she did.
And I feel like this is one of those songs where you look in the mirror and you're just like, you come to that moment where you're just like, I'm the problem. It is me.
Yeah.
I'm the anti-hero. I put people in uncomfortable situations. I put myself in uncomfortable situations.
Yeah, yeah.
And then, hindsight, I bitch about them. Okay, well, that's odd because you're not doing anything to get out of it, but you've also put yourself in it. So mm-hmm. which one is it?
Like, even the covert narcissism, like, bringing in the idea of being a narcissist in and kind of, like, calling that out about yourself.
Absolutely. And that's a hard thing to do.
To start off with Lavender Haze and talk a little bit about how people view you,
mm-hmm.
and then to dig into that later... is a really interesting choice.
Absolutely.
Because that also, you know, helps magnify how big of a deal it is when someone comes along and says, I'm going to love you despite that. And then obviously, Taylor has that moment too where she loves herself despite that. And this, while this is a song talking about how she never recognizes it, it's still a song of her recognizing it. If you catch
honestly,
that, it literally is.
Yes, absolutely.
So that's the kind of moments that we have in life.
Wow, I
think that's a great song.
I'm speechless.
And Sexy Baby is a reference, okay? Yeah. It is an expression borrowed from an episode of the Tina Fey helmed sitcom 30 Rock.
That's fine.
Yeah. Sounds like Christmas time.
No, look, seriously.
One night a few moons ago I saw
I love that.
Flex. Of what could have been lights, but life is emotionally abusive, and time can't stop me quite like you did. And it's like snow at the beach, weird but fucking beautiful. Snow on the beach.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
There's snow on the beach.
Oh, that's nice. Oh, I love that.
This sea feels what I once saw on a screen. I've never seen someone live from within. My smile is like I want a contest. Till you do, till it's true. But it's coming down, no sound. It's all around. It's coming on the beach.
Hey!
Are we falling like snow at the beach? We're fucking beautiful. You wanted me tonight. It's impossible. It's coming down.
Oh, wow.
I liked that one more than I thought I was going to.
Really?
Yeah. I wasn't sure because we haven't listened to Lana Del Rey like that yet.
We only got to the country.
Yeah, we haven't gotten to, you know, Born to Die, Ultra Violence. We haven't delved
into that.
Into that yet.
Yeah.
So for me, I was like, I couldn't really imagine how Taylor and Lana would come together. But I actually love how they did it. You know, they could have gone that standard route of you take a verse, I'll take a verse, we'll come together on the chorus. Maybe we'll do a little something on the bridge.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It could have been that. But it was more of a duet, and they played on the differences in their voices and in their sound.
Yes.
And I love how it was more harmonies than anything. And, like, Lana was kind of like this... Ooh, y'all can see my knee. Lana was more like this echo.
Yes.
That I loved.
And I was going to say, I can so tell... when Lana has her hands on something.
Yeah.
And this just sounds
Yes.
Like
they were definitely leaning more into Lana's sound.
You know, Lana's sound.
Which is different for Taylor.
Right.
Right.
And I appreciate that.
Yeah.
I absolutely love this song. I think
it was good.
It, you know, being like falling in love and just experiencing that right back.
Mm-hmm.
It's such a beautiful feeling. So again, it feels like snow on the beach. It's
yeah.
Because it's two very beautiful things. So when you put them together, that's why it's so
coming together. Yeah, it's just
it's
a beautiful thing.
So weird.
Thing. Yeah, yeah.
You know, it's weird, but it's, you know, fucking beautiful.
It's a weird fucking beautiful. You know.
You know the unlikelihood of that falling in love and then just what those feelings bring. So I think it comes at a perfect point in the album.
Yes, it does.
I will say this though.
What's that?
Something I've noticed as we listen. I feel like the album stays in this very neutral place sonically.
Okay.
It's very calm. It's very, you know, relaxed. It's chill. It kind of gets upbeat, but it never fully takes off.
Okay.
So it's keeping me in this sort of, like, dreamlike state.
Yes.
And it's keeping that alternative sound. I don't know if you're getting this, too. I like the sound coming off of Evermore and Folklore because there's still something that feels very similar. And I think it's the way that her vocals are layered.
Yes. It doesn't sound too poppy.
Yeah, it's not like a complete 180.
It's not exactly because I feel
she's
like
playing,
that one,
she's giving you like the best of both worlds. She's feeding you, you know, ooh, if 1989 is next.
Oh my gosh.
That is perfect. But she's kind of, you know, playing in the middle here because I feel like on your 10th album, you know, if you listen to all of Taylor's projects from what we've listened to, you know, and what we've heard, they're very different, you know, and we've seen her go through all of these phases.
Summer went away. The yearning stays. I wait patiently. He's gonna notice me. We're the best of friends. Anyway,
well,
I hear it in your voice. You're smoking with your voice. I touch my phone as it fits your face.
Okay, don't do that no more. Don't do that no more.
What?
Touch your phone as if it's your phone. Okay, I literally imagined Taylor laying down.
I know.
Right here. Picks it up and just...
I know.
Don't do that no more.
I know.
I could be completely wrong, but that's what I pictured.
I know.
There's just one who could make me stay all my days.
I love them.
Sprinkler splashes. I search the party of their bodies just to learn that you never cared. You're on your own, kid. You always have been.
Uh-oh.
I see the great.
Sounds like a train. Ooh, it sounds like a train getting away. Like, kind of like drifting from that feeling
leaving
or moving away from
leaving the town.
That's up there for me. Okay, but this bridge though.
I looked around the blood soaked gown.
Okay.
One, I think of Carrie. You know, when that moment was taken from her.
That brings me to my point. You're on the right track. Okay.
And I saw something they can never take away.
Yeah, they can't. I was thinking industry. I gave my blood, sweat, and tears for this career, to be in this place in my life. I hosted parties and starved my body. The jokes weren't funny. I took the money, which means like maybe she showed up to some parties, showed up to some events,
and got paid
through
for
scrutiny
it.
And just got paid for it and left. She took her money and left.
So,
but her friends from home
don't know what to say. It's like I don't recognize you. Which is so interesting because this song went from a song about love to a song about where she is in life.
Yeah.
And it's like,
Taylor, when you're on your own.
When you're on your own, Taylor, you have to remember that you cannot depend on anybody in this room, not the boy, not anybody in this industry. You're on your own, kid. You always have been.
Exactly.
But you can do this.
She's like, I'm reading
that.
Here. I didn't even know this. She suffered from an eating disorder.
I didn't know that. I did not know that.
Yeah, and just like, what she's endured. Like, just
that some of us don't even know about. Like, what the hell?
Yeah, and she reveals it little by little through her lyrics. I'm seeing that there are some references back to like Exile, back to Evermore, All Too Well, things that she's addressed before, the jokes weren't funny.
I thought the song was amazing.
Bridges Burned, yeah. So this is just really a young person who longs for love but eventually understands that they are on their own as the song progresses toward its conclusion. Yeah,
it was amazing.
He wanted a comfortable, I wanted the pain. He wanted a bread, I was taking my own name. Okay, I knew it. It's reminiscent of the first track, Lavender Haze. He wanted a bride, I was making my own name. First of all, that intro
is amazing.
Intriguing. Very intriguing.
Amazing.
My town was a wasteland.
Was a wasteland left?
The cages, yeah. The fences, pageant queens and pretenders. But for some, it was paradise. I broke his heart because he was nice. He was sunshine, I was midnight.
He wanted a comfortable, I wanted that.
The last song she left, she realized, hey, you're on your own, kid.
Yeah.
You have to start deciding and making decisions for yourself.
Yeah.
And when she did, she said, he wanted a comfortable, I wanted pain. He wanted a bride, I wanted my own name. She chased the fame, he saved the same. Like,
he was sunshine, I was midnight rain. We're two different.
We're two different people.
Wow.
We're two different people. And I love this. This deep voice. What?
I guess sometimes we all get just what we wanted, and he never thinks of me. When I'm on TV,
wow.
I never think of him. Except on midnight.
Like this.
Title track?
This is the title track. Come on now. That's a hit.
Y'all gotta give it to that one.
That's a hit. Wow, that was short.
254 is a crime. So that's another one of my favorites.
Oh, that's one of my favorites.
That was very different.
That was, first of all, it's the title track.
Yeah, it is. You can't tell me nothing different.
You can't tell me nothing different. For that to kind of encompass what Midnights is about, it's about
finding yourself.
That and change.
That and change,
that
yeah.
That and change.
Yeah, very true.
And again, these contrasts. A lot of these songs have to do with contrast.
They do have a contrast.
And how you have your black and your white. And some areas fill up that gray, that gray area.
Yeah.
It's Taylor's evolution.
You know, sometimes small towns, small minds.
Yes.
You know? And when you're thinking beyond that, sometimes you have to get out of surroundings. You have to get out. You have to uproot yourself and take yourself out of situations where there is no growth. I think for her to speak on that, there are definitely similarities to You're On Your Own, Kid. It's almost like You're On Your Own, Kid is the lesson.
Yes.
And Midnight Rain is the payoff.
Yes.
But the realization.
Yes, yes, yes.
If
you literally just
sense.
Took the word out of my mouth. You're On Your Own, Kid is the lesson. Midnight Rain is the payoff. It is the lesson learned.
Yeah. Maybe she learned the lesson, but didn't see how necessary it was.
Yeah.
To leave that person, whatever the case may be. I feel like there are some differences, but there's enough similarities to where you can connect the two.
Yeah, no, that was...
Yeah.
That was a great song.
I love that.
Wow, I'm thoroughly impressed so far. Wow.
Good girl, sad boy, big city, wrong choices. I swear that it was something, cause I don't remember who I was before you painted all my nights. Fucking situations, circumstances, miscommunications, and I have to say, by the way, can I ask you a question? Did you ever have someone kiss you in a crowded room? And every single one of your friends was making fun of you. Then what did you do?
That's nice.
Did you leave her house in the middle of the night?
Oh, I like that.
She was on your mind with some dickhead guy that you saw that night. But you were on something. It was one drink after fucking politics and gender roles. And you're not sure and I don't know, girl.
In the gray.
Question.
Ooh, that beat.
Did you ever have someone kiss you in a crowded room? Did you leave her house in the middle of the night? Did you wish you'd put up more of a fight? Does it feel like everything's just like second?
I don't like this woman. I truly don't. No. And especially now,
there's something very dark about her. You don't do that.
You don't have me now, you know, about to be 8 songs in, and yeah. I still am hype and still full of surprise.
So the song is a little risque,
a little rainbow. Once you start just unraveling things, you just start to question things. And it's moments in life that make you feel a certain way and you want to know why. Yeah. Sometimes good, sometimes bad. In this moment, it's almost like Taylor yearned for a little more.
And you know, this is the perfect album to kind of explore that on too, because, absolutely, you know, with her saying that this album is in a way about what you can discover at midnight with your thoughts, sleepless nights. I'm careful with things like this.
Yeah, I don't want to assume.
Because I don't want to just say that's what it is, who that's about. So we're going to leave things up to interpretation with that.
But for this, but
I love how she poses questions in the song, you know? Like, even if she is talking about a dude, or if she's observing and getting into the mind of somebody else, I don't know who she's talking about. Because she starts off with Good Girl, Sad Boy, you know? So it really could go either way with whoever she's talking about.
Yeah, it's really good.
It feels kind of like a chaotic song, too.
It is a little bit.
Just questioning any and everything. And I love the ambiguity of that too.
Yeah.
It's just a question. And no, damn money, no question.
I'm kind of leaving it up to your interpretation. It's basically what it is. I also love it sonically.
Same.
I'm thoroughly, thoroughly impressed with this album. This is a great album.
So far, it's different. This has been a different experience.
And it's beyond cohesive.
The way she was posing the questions, it's almost like she was looking for confirmation for herself.
She's like, probably looking in the mirror.
In a way, but it's like, I'm going to ask you these questions because on the low, I'm not feeling these things. And I want to know if someone else is feeling them. That way I know I'm not
alone
in it. Or I'm not crazy. Or like, I'm not wrong in what I'm actually thinking.
Yeah.
Draw the cat eyes sharp enough to kill a man.
Oh.
You did some bad things, but I'm the worst of them. I don't dress for women. I don't dress for men. I've been dressing for revenge. I don't start shit, but I can tell you how it ends.
Look, Taylor.
I don't dress for friends. Lately I've been dressing for revenge.
Love that.
She needed cold hard proof, so I gave her some.
Come on.
She had the envelope. Where you think she got it from? With your ex-wife.
Blow up that relationship. Blow it up.
Nobody knows.
Yeah.
Crime. That's all this.
Yeah, that's what keeps going through your head, right?
That's all keeps going through my head.
She says, where do you think she got it from?
Where do you think she got it from, playa?
She got it from.
And she looks so pretty. Driving in your Benz. Lately she's been dressing for revenge.
Okay.
Well, I love this beat.
Don't get sad, get even. Ladies always rise above. Ladies know what people want.
You did not just cut it off like that. I need to hear that.
Someone sweet and kind and fun. The ladies simply hide in love. Well, he was doing lies.
You should see me in the crown. That's what that reminds me of.
Julian. I'm gonna get her. This right here.
This is.
Lock her up.
Lock her up.
Lock her up. I'm tired of the criminal activity.
And I'm taking the envelope.
Yeah. You want to be a vigilante? Let me show you what happens.
Crossing all of mine. Someone told us white collar crimes.
Mm-hmm.
To the FBI. I'm on the vigilante shit again.
Oh.
I don't start shit, but I can tell you how it ends. Lately I've been dressing for revenge.
That's gonna be my top three.
Yeah,
hands down, that's gonna be my top three.
You know, this is a very controversial opinion, I'm sure, but I would say that's top five off the album.
That's not controversial, that is the truth.
It's just my hip hop mind, but
you put a remix with a rapper on that shit?
Oh.
Holy shit.
Oh.
Holy shit.
What? Holy shit.
Yeah.
Listen.
Holy exalted shit.
That is so different for Taylor. And that paint reminds me of You Should See Me in a Crown.
She got, like, in a really dark bag. But once again, she's playing with stories. She's playing with characters.
Yes, yes. And
I love that she's kept that.
I put it, like, next to it.
Yeah.
I think that's so far one of the best songs on the album.
The way the shortest songs on the album
are amazing.
And some of the best.
Wow.
Now I don't get the house, gets the kids, gets the
She's
pride.
On her vigilante shit.
She is.
She is going to write...
Yeah.
Every wrong, the way she wants to right every wrong.
Yeah.
If that's taking the man down, that's taking the man down.
Yeah, because it's, you know, if she is playing the mistress here, it's like, this is how, you know, you played me, guess what?
And you know,
I gotta play you too.
That could also go towards a certain record label that let her down.
Could.
Because as you guys can see, she's about to sell 1.2 million without you.
Baby love, I think I've been a little too kind.
After that?
Uh-huh.
Didn't notice you walking all over my peace of mind.
Like...
And the shoes I gave you as a present, wishing someone first only works when you're in their top five.
Oh! That's good.
I want to see that on Instagram.
On every single Instagram post.
Yeah,
I do.
This strikes me as, like, her realization before she gets on her vigilante shit.
Yes.
Like, once she realizes how you've been walking over her peace of mind.
Yeah.
That's when she decides that I'm not going to be anymore. Because the way I'm stepping out tonight.
And she said, by the way, I'm going out, so I'm not asking you.
Right.
I'm telling you.
Best believe I'm still bejeweled. When I walk in the room, I can still make the whole place shimmer. Familiarity breeds contempt. Don't put me in the basement when I'm on the penthouse of your heart. I polish up real nice.
Hey.
I like this.
Baby boy, I think I've been too good of a girl. Too good of a girl. I need you my world. Have you heard how I can reclaim the land? And when I meet the band, they ask, do you have a man? I can still say I don't remember. Time is in my eyes. I polish up real nice. Sapphire tears on my face. Sadness became my whole sky.
There is a Moonstone vinyl of the album, and I'm pretty sure Midnight's on, like, the cover is written in that Moonstone color.
Oh, interesting.
And you can try to change my mind, but you might have to wait in line. Mm. What's a girl gonna do? A diamond's gotta shine.
Hey.
Wow, that's a hit to me.
You know, I was gonna say, right? That song, I think, is the first one to remind me a lot more of Taylor's earlier pop days.
It reminds me of, like, 1999 on Reputation.
Reputation lover for me. Like, somewhere in there. It definitely gives me those vibes.
I was actually seen on Twitter.
Mm.
Some Bejeweled hate.
You know what I saw?
You know, before listening.
You know what I saw?
What did you see?
That Bejeweled was struggling. To make the top 100. I'm not sure if they did it or not, but it was struggling.
Damn, damn.
And I don't really know why.
I don't know why either. I actually love that song. I think it's a beautiful song about realizing when someone dims your light and they don't allow you to shine. And then when you do finally step out and you're like, hold on.
Yeah.
Hold on, motherfucker.
Yeah.
I can still play this.
I still got it. And it's not even about, you know, discovering your own self-worth. It's about, I know my worth.
I don't know my worth. Exactly.
That's the problem.
Exactly.
I don't have to discover anything.
And this just,
you do.
This just proves my theory that you don't know just that.
Let me remind you that because even if I didn't want to be taken, I have that
because
choice.
Because they say there is nothing like feeling down, mm-hmm. and then a stranger kind of compliments you or mm-hmm. makes a move towards you, and you're like, shit.
Mm-hmm.
I'm still hot shit.
Absolutely. That's why she says, I can, if when they ask do I have a boyfriend, I can say, I don't remember.
I actually really liked Bejeweled.
Okay, vocals. Hold on. She said, y'all forgot.
Yeah, wow.
She sounds gorgeous.
The high register sounds amazing.
Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. I'll be getting
anything worth having comes easy.
Yeah.
I can stand 10 toes down and say that's probably in my top three.
Really?
I'm safe to say I have my top three.
Your top three is coming easy. It's another example of a beat that like never fully took off. Yeah. It's reflecting the title very well. This song just gives me like hope. Because like to say I thought the plane was going down, how'd you turn it right around? You know, love is tumultuous. When you've been through a lot of different relationships or scenarios, you know, you can begin to give up. So when someone comes along and restores that faith, restores like, that hope,
oh my gosh.
You're like, at the same time, you're like, oh no, because like this could either repeat, you know, a pattern or it's going to be different.
You don't know whether to trust it.
But you're also surprised at the fact that someone was still able to break through.
Yes.
That wall, you know?
Yes,
so
absolutely.
Labyrinth being, you know, similar to like a maze. I ain't going to lie. I had to look it up. I said, what is this?
Yeah, I had to.
I thought that it was a creature. I'm not going to lie. I did.
Yeah, a beautiful song about falling in love again. And I love how Taylor explained kind of the heartbreak at first and how hard it is and how you tell yourself like it's only going to be a little while and then you're like, you come to the realization, you're like, no, damn it, I'm never going to be able to just forget and let it go. So when you do fall in love with somebody, you're like, you almost feel guilty. And it's like, dang, should I trust this? I absolutely loved this song.
You're talking shit for the hell of it. You're terrified to look down. Cause if you dare, you see the glare of everyone you burn just to get there. And I keep my side of the street clean. Your little webs of opacity, my pennies made your crown.
Wow.
Oh, my pennies made your crown.
Jordan,
the money I made you.
Yeah.
I made you a lot of money. Like, and that crown, that throne that you sit on, I believe she spoke about a throne before.
Yes.
Just how you sit on that as if it wasn't off my back. She said, me and Karma are tight. Me and Karma are close. Sure, Karma has my back. Karma knows me.
Karma,
okay? Karma
has
my number.
Treat me once, treat me twice. Don't you know the cash ain't the only price? It's coming back around. Sweet like honey, Karma is a cat. Purring in my lap cause it loves me. Flexing like a goddamn acrobat. Gonna track you down step by step from town to town. Sweet like justice, Karma is a queen. Karma is the guy on the screen coming straight home to me.
Okay.
Karma is my boyfriend.
Hey.
Karma's a relaxing
side. I love that line.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, Gwen,
Karma gets a like. Karma gets a like. The reason why I love Karma as a relaxing thought is because it's this idea that justice will be served. And she can sit back and relax knowing that that will be the case.
Yeah.
At some point.
Yeah.
At some point, Karma is going to get you. Karma's coming. I can chill.
Yeah,
knowing that.
Because I know that I've been nothing but genuine with you.
Yeah.
And to me, this song's about La Scooter and all of them.
I think it could be about that.
I think a lot of this has to do with that.
Yeah.
And just how, you know, so much was taken away. But again, like they say, what goes around comes around.
Yeah.
Like, what you took from me, you're gonna reap what you sow.
Yeah.
Like, you, and so...
A letter to the world.
I didn't think that's the route that Karma was gonna take.
Oh, that's what sonically, I wanted. Sonically. That's what I wanted.
Sonically, but that was an incredible song.
Yeah.
Damn. I love the way that Karma was described.
Same. Because
Karma is so many things.
It can come in so many shapes and forms.
Yes.
You never know what it could be. And, like, I just had this recently. Yeah. Like, you know... Like, if someone does you wrong, like, you may have an idea of what you want to happen. Like, sometimes you want them to be hurt in the same way. But sometimes life gets them in another way that hurts even worse.
Thank you. And pays
them back in a way that you couldn't have come up with, you know?
Yeah.
And I feel like karma plays a very long game, too. So you never know when it's going to hit.
That's true.
So that's why it's best to kind of just let go and let God. Maybe in this case, let go, let karma. Let go and let life. Let life just do what it's going to do. Yeah, karma's a God.
That we picked up last July, down deep inside your pocket. They said the end is coming, everyone's up to something. I found myself running onto your sweet nothings. All that you ever wanted from me was sweet nothing.
Wow.
On the way home, I wrote a poem. You say, what am I?
You're
in the kitchen humming. All that you ever wanted from me was nothing. Industry disruptors and soul deconstructors and smooth talking hucksters. You should be doing more. To you, I can admit that I'm just too soft for all of it. They said the end is coming. They said the end is coming. Everyone's up to something. I find myself running to your sweet nothing.
That one was very sweet.
Yeah.
Pun intended.
I think when I look at that, it's that the outside world has so much going on.
Mm-hmm.
So when I come home, you don't really want much from me. So that feeling is sweet. It's nice to feel at peace and at home and comfortable and kind of let the guard down, let her hair down. That's kind of how I take this.
I've always loved the idea that you know something is good when you feel comfortable in the silence.
Yes.
When you can sit with someone, lay with someone, be with someone, and you don't feel like you have to overcompensate, keep a conversation going, keep them entertained.
Yeah.
You can sense that they feel comfortable in your presence and you feel comfortable in theirs. And so I like this double of sweet nothings, because it's sweet that you want nothing from me.
Yeah.
Like you were saying, because the world is so chaotic, because maybe even because of who she is, the world demands so much of her that when she's around this person, I'm going to assume that this is Joe. He's not needing all of that from her. And she can just be Taylor. And then also the sweet nothings, things that are maybe seen as nothing or seen as little or seen as a given in a relationship actually mean a lot.
Yeah.
Like, keeping that pebble. And to find herself running home to those things, maybe because they're simple.
I love that. And it definitely feels like we're nearing the end of the album.
Yeah, so, it definitely feels like that.
Yeah.
And I was thinking to myself, I said, you know, I really like this number 13, but it would be really cool to have 12 tracks because 12, it's midnight, 12 o'clock.
Yeah.
But I've been waiting to say this the entire time, but Mastermind is the song I am most excited for.
Really?
Because I don't know what it is, but, like, you know how we always claim a track?
Yeah.
I've been claiming this one, so I want to see what this sounds like and how she takes it out.
Interesting.
Once upon a time, the planet's in the face. reaction of counter moves. Checkmate, I couldn't lose. What if I told you none of it was accidental? And the first night that you saw me, nothing was gonna stop me. Just like clockwork, the dominoes cascading in a line. What if I told you I'm a mastermind?
Okay.
It was all by design. You see, all the wisest women had to do it this way. Cause we were born to be the pawn in every lover's game.
I love that.
If you fail to plan, you plan to fail. And the liquor in our cocktails. What if I told you none of it was accidental? I knew I wanted your body. I laid the groundwork, and now you're mine.
Julian, I'm sorry. I have to. Okay.
I think this is all coming.
This is my favorite.
Really?
I am so happy right now. This is my favorite. What this song is doing for me right now, I love this. I love everything about this.
Listening.
Sonically, lyrically, just like. I love everything about this.
To play with me as a little kid, so I've been scheming like a criminal ever since.
Wow, I like that callback.
And make it seem effortless. This is the first time I felt the need to confess, cause I can't. So I told you none of it was accidental. In the verse, saw a wide smirk on your face. You knew the entire time. You knew that I'm a mastermind.
I cannot.
Cause I'm a mastermind.
Oh wow, what a different way to take the album out. Oh wow, that was so different.
My heart.
Literally.
That is my song.
I concocted all of this.
Yeah, that's mine.
I constructed all of this. I'm a mastermind.
I can't wipe this off my face. Like that song, that is.
I made you fall in love with me.
That is...
But, like, you knew!
Oh, my God. Yeah.
Just that's, like, some movie type shit.
The beat. Like, oh, what did I just listen to? Taylor.
I'm
that
sorry.
That was the sweetest thing. But like, also so truthful.
Truthful, but conniving. I don't know.
But
it's true. It was good.
But it's true. Like, when she says the line about how, like, women being pawns.
Yeah.
Or, you know, just, like, how sometimes in life, like, you literally have to... do things that way.
Hell yeah.
She has the mind of a mastermind.
She has like the mind of a master, like the mind of a, like a,
it's crazy because we reference that so much.
So much.
See, I'm telling you, I have the mind of a master. I have the mind of a mastermind. What's that? I don't know, but.
And then like for this to be what it was.
Yeah.
And my favorite song, like this is mine. This might be my favorite Taylor Swift song right now, like maybe ever.
Wow.
Like this is up there with Wonderland for me.
Wow.
I can't even.
No, it was. It's so interesting because the album ends on such a confident note.
Yes.
And I love that.
I think this was the first song that was revealed.
Yes, it was.
I knew that you were scheming. I knew what you were doing, but I liked it. And I wanted it too.
Yeah.
So I let it happen.
Wow.
I don't want to see any mastermind slander that song.
Now,
I loved it so much. I wanted another chorus. I wanted it to get even bigger. Like, ooh, it was swelling up for me. Like, Taylor, can you release an extended version?
I would really like that.
Just for me.
Let's talk about Midnights.
Yeah.
Wow, coming off the high of Mastermind,
we
have Midnights. I mean, dare I say finally, because honestly, we didn't wait that long
for
the album. Like, we truly didn't.
Yeah.
But, I mean, like, this album, it suits Taylor so well.
It does.
Like, when I tell you I am so impressed, the fact that, to me, you have a couple of perfect songs on an album. I think, like you said, it's a beautiful continuation from Evermore,
mm-hmm.
but you immediately feel the switch.
Yeah.
It's in the details.
Yeah. Oh.
Everything was in the details.
Yeah, I want to talk about details.
I think this album is very detail-oriented. The thing that's so crazy is it doesn't follow a huge storyline.
No.
But the storyline in itself is the 13 sleepless nights.
Yeah, that's the...
That's the storyline. Yeah. At some point in time, you have felt...
Yeah.
And one of these emotions. I really like where you're going in your discography, Taylor.
Yeah.
I'm genuinely impressed, and you have some of my favorite songs of yours on this album. I might have to buy every single vinyl because this shit was good.
There's four.
And I will.
I love that Taylor's in this place where it doesn't feel like she's trying to top herself. I feel like she is now exploring. When it comes to the production on this album, piggybacking off you saying that it's about the details, she plugged in so many different elements you know, throughout the songs, whether it was a horn, whether it was a little synth or a weird sound or just like the way a song would begin. She did a lot of different things in that way,
yeah,
which is what I was noticing as we were listening. So not only is the dream pop, alt pop, alternative, lo-fi, whatever you want to call it, sound different, but the way that the songs are constructed is different as well.
It's just good.
They're notably like shorter. But I feel like we also got so much with Folklore and Evermore.
Yeah.
That this is just a nice something for us to get, which is so wild because the way that it's about to do 1 million in the first week, like this album has broken records already. Like, this is insane.
I'm thoroughly impressed. I still think 10 Toes Down, Anti-Hero is my favorite song on this album. To me, that is a perfect song. I love that song.
Well, y'all know mine. But I love the fact that Lavender Haze and Mastermind kind of end in the same place.
Yeah.
Which makes it more cohesive topic-wise.
Yeah.
Again.
It was
just I think it's a great album. I'm looking forward to the 3 a.m.
Yeah, me too.
One.
And the music videos. Yes. I'm looking forward to it all. It's really exciting.
It's a visual album. Wait, we didn't even say that.
Oh,
isn't it a visual album?
As always, we'd love to know what you guys thought about this amazing album. Let us know your top 5. Down below in the comments.
If you enjoyed watching us react, remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on your post notifications, that way you know when we upload. And we'll catch you guys on the next one.